To date, more than 80% of the world's energy needs are still met with environmentally harmful energy, such as nuclear, coal, oil, and gas. The main reason behind this is a complex and outdated power generation and supply system, which is loaded with legislation and dominated by large players. But as in other sectors, there are many young companies that want to change the energy sector in the long term. One of these startups is Lithion from Berlin.
So today's market structure, for example, in Germany, but also in many other countries, was designed decades ago. And back then, decades ago, we had a very centralized power structure. And it worked back then. But now, 20 years fast forward, the world has changed. A decentralized approach, like for example with blockchain technology, can be the key to unlock this opportunity. I mean, with Bitcoins and when the first cryptocurrencies came up, you were able to transfer money from one person to another without a bank. Why shouldn't this be also possible with kilowatt hours?
Also from Berlin is the startup Grid Singularity, which is dedicated to the transformation of the energy market. A fundamental cornerstone in this process is blockchain technology.
Grid Singularity is a company that is more of a social entrepreneurship, where we have taken on this challenge of energy market transformation and are deploying new technologies to put the individual and the environment at the forefront of the market. Blockchain is a technology, one of the tools that we need to transform the energy market to reach what today are challenges and buzzwords such as sector coupling and coordinating distributed energy resources. Currently, the energy market is very distributed, but we still manage it in a way that is mainly centralized. We talk about decentralized solutions, but we don't actually deploy them very well. We have been slow to innovate in the energy market, and more the individuals are asking where my energy comes from, what can I do to improve the energy transition, and therefore we need solutions to involve the individual and to put the individual and the environment back at the center of the issue.
As a result of the protests of the Fridays for Future movement, the origins of electricity consumed in households is increasingly coming into focus for consumers. Lithion co-founder Dr. Kyung-hun Ha also sees great potential for startups in this area.
Well, if I look at the energy sector, I would say intransparency and complexity are the two things that stand out in my opinion. And from an end customer perspective, you don't really know what is really going on. So the usual case is that you decide for yourself for a specific energy company, but where the energy is really sourced from, you don't really know that. And I think this is a huge problem because nowadays people want to know where your energy is coming from.
Increasing the transparency of the market also makes the democratization of the market possible. Anna Turbovich of Grid Singularity sees this as an important lever for a successful energy transition.
Democratization of the energy market is a level playing field where an individual has adequate information and not asymmetric information, as is the case now, and easy to use tools to participate in the market and to choose their source of energy, to decide if they want to change their behavior or invest to decrease the reliance on non-renewable resources.
The two founders of Lithion explain what a democratic and transparent system looks like in practice.
Well, I think there are three things Lithion truly stands for. So first of all, it's the digitization, it's decarbonization, and it's democratization.
In the Lithion Energy platform, which we've designed a peer-to-peer trading model, so from a producer to a consumer, it basically works like a marketplace, like an auction, where you have sellers putting in supply options, or sell orders, and then buyers like consumers that take these sell orders with buy orders, and then the market does a matching. And then you have also an efficient system where you as a consumer can choose the power plant you want to have.
Power to the people means giving people the freedom, you know, become prosumer on one hand side, but also, you know, to choose what to do with the energy.
Around 1.7 million solar panels are installed on the roofs of German houses. The installations produced around 47 terawatt hours of electricity in 2019. For a few years now, Frank Jakob also has a solar panel system on the roof of his house, which, thanks to market partners, generates electricity not only for himself.
We, in fact, installed a solar system on our house. Basically, three major components. There's the panels on the rooftop. There's inverters, and there's also a battery system, energy storage system, and makes us for most parts of the year almost completely independent of any external energy or electricity supply. To do that, basically there were three different motivations. First of all, this is our contribution to prevent climate change and to save the planet. Secondly, there's also a commercial dimension. We're running a power plant and we're producing energy for ourselves, so we don't need to buy it anymore. We produce more than what we consume, so we put that to the public distribution grid. We get compensations from national schemes for that purpose, and in addition to that, we also sell it to the market.
Startups can initiate a turnaround with their products and innovations, but they often fail due to regulatory hurdles.
I think the key challenges for technological adoption in the energy sector is not a technical part. That is solvable, and that has been solved in multiple industries too. And yes, we have excellent coders and they make the difference. But I think the key part in the energy sector is to combine modern technology with the specific regulation that every country has. Because you can work on the most beautiful technology, which is super fast, super secure, and easily accessible. But if it doesn't work in the regulatory environment, you will not reach people.
The climate change is a global thing. Energy policy, energy management, energy business is mostly handled on a national level. Well, there is a European grid, energy grid, but for example, I could not sell my solar energy to a customer in France while the grid connects us, in fact. Yeah.
In addition to the legislation, the market participants must also cooperate on shared technologies to create joint standards, as the other co-founder of Grid Singularity, Ewald Hesse, explained to us.
This is the first time in history of the energy market that there is a joint layer created on a global scale. To achieve a global transition, I think there is two necessary steps. On the one side, the economics have to work, and the whole world already supported this a lot through incentives. So we see economies of scale and renewables already. The second one is creating joint systems.
What should a democratic energy market look like in the future? Dr. Richard Lohwasser has a precise idea of this.
Our vision would be that maybe in a couple of years, in a couple of decades, legislation and the regulatory framework changes in such a way that decentralized electricity production can become less dependent on individual players, can become less centralized and move more into a decentral approach, where you have the grid, the producer and the consumer communicating on one data layer with an open technology such as blockchain.
Digitalization of the energy sector can turn pure consumers into active market participants who can not only meet their own energy needs with sustainable, renewable energy, but also the needs of their neighbors and communities.